So let's talk about technology and St. Paul, Minnesota.
Yeah, the school board in St. Paul has voted to give students individual iPads. They've made a deal with Apple. They're going to give individual iPads to students, which has restarted the debate about and the skepticism about innovative technology being brought into the classroom.
This is an amazing adventure that we're about to embark on, that really the whole country is looking at what we're doing. So hopefully we're making the right choice.
That was back in 2013, not long before LA Unified recalled the devices they had issued. But the initiatives continue, the latest coming from St. Paul, Minnesota, where the school board has just approved a deal with Apple to provide iPads for each student. Though some are concerned that the initial cost could be nearly $6 million annually, St. Paul's Assistant Superintendent for Personalized Learning, Kate Wilcox-Harris, told reporters, "Our students are millennials who have tremendous digital fluency, and we must tap into that." Choice Media has also spoken to successful providers of ed tech, like Belterre Elementary School in Florida, which has given students in one class iPads that they can take home with their legal guardian's permission.
I can keep, like, billions and billions and billions of things in here, and I don't have to go searching through the thing. I can just go to the search bar and type in the note name.
What about your book bag? Has that been heavy this year?
No.
All right, so denying some exercise to these kids who might be carrying book bags that could then make them be healthy.
Or strain on their lower backs, depending on how you look at it.
All right, and I think that you and I may have a bit of an honest disagreement on this issue. I generally view this as kind of an inputs thing. If you just, let's pay for more stuff and throw it at kids, and then they'll all be smarter. And if they really wanted to reform things in St. Paul, Minnesota, the best thing to do would be, like, let principals hire and fire who they want, for example. And then if they're no good, replace them. Like that kind of a reform, much more than throwing a bunch of iPads into the schools.
But the way I see it is that iPads are basically just 21st century textbooks. And with textbooks being phased out, they now have this technology where they can access all the information, their entire lessons right there on this one little tablet. Nothing gets lost unless the device is destroyed, which could potentially happen. But I mean,
Textbooks, however, can be dropped, and iPads can be dropped too, and there's a different result usually with those two. I mean, so in other words, kids often will, spill beverages or drop computers or destroy them or sell them or lose them or all that
stuff. Right, and yet you might say that riding your horse to school is more green than taking the bus, but that technology has been pretty effective for students overall.
Okay, so your view is that the school bus is a kind of innovation, they don't get to keep their school bus.
The school bus could break down.
It's not owned. It's not kept by the student. It's kept by adults. But anyway, so Bill, why don't you help us out here? Weigh in on this. Do you see this as an inputs thing of throwing money at a school when other kinds of reforms make more sense? Or do you agree with him that it's a modern era and it's time for a textbook to reflect that?
Well, it is a modern era, and we are seeing a growing shift toward digital education, and personally, I welcome that. I celebrate that. I encourage that. I think there are all sorts of technological innovations that can and should facilitate the learning of students. Having said that, I think there is a tendency on the part of many in the education world to think, what we need to do now is to take the kind of latest shiny object, put it in front of kids, and that's going to magically solve all of our education problems. And I guess to me, the thing that most needs to happen in terms of kind of harnessing the power of digital education is to say, hey, wait a minute, if kids can learn online now, do we necessarily need to continue to have a paradigm for thinking about education that says schooling is something that happens in a brick-and-mortar building during a particular time of day, during a particular time of the year? And indeed, here in Florida, one of the things that I think has been revolutionary is that with the development of the Florida Virtual School and other online innovations, we now have students who are taking classes year-round.
Your message is be careful what you wish for, education establishment. If you throw a bunch of new technology at kids, next thing you know, they don't need to hear a below average Algebra 2 lesson ever again because they have a device in front of them that can give them the best Algebra 2 lesson in the world.
Yeah, no, I mean, if you think about how the internet has kind of disrupted all sorts of other fields.
Sure.
There's no reason why online digital education can't, in many ways, spur innovation and reform.
All right,
in
but
the world
Florida, are there any Florida districts where every kid gets a free iPad?
I don't know. The story that you mentioned is focused on at least a particular school, and there has been a growing interest in our state in supplying students with digital
the school I mentioned in the story.
And internet access and things of that nature. But ultimately, to me, the key is rethinking everything related to education. The school
the
year,
when
we could get...
Yeah, hold on,
get,
Bill. So the school in the story with the... with
Belterre Elementary School is in Palm Coast, Florida, yeah.
All right, and so they I guess they have that. So, and the bottom line, too, look, I love technology. I just think it makes more sense to keep it at the school, and they can stay late, and they can, whatever, use the computers all they want, and I think that's a great thing. I would support all that. It's just a question of whether you let an 8-year-old take an iPad home.